Well, on this brisk morning, I'm with Burl from Rare Plant Research, and what a beautiful site that we're at today. And we're not going to really dwell on that it's going to be coming cold, but you were really surprised about this last winter on successes in the garden that kind of surprised you.
Yes, that's true. There were some things that we were actually quite surprised about, and then we had a couple disappointments, too.
Well, let's talk about a surprise or a good success. With this Tradescantia, Moses in a Boat, it's just beautiful.
Yes, it is amazing. You know, when we first heard that it was hardy, I couldn't believe it. And so we tried it out. It freezes back to the ground in the wintertime, and you think it's dead, and in the spring, up it comes, and it looks just like this. You can see, quite vigorous.
It is, you know, and I've just put them in my containers or my baskets, and then I just kind of chuck them. So it's nice that they can put them into the landscape and have this gorgeous kind of ground cover.
Oh, they're just wonderful, wonderful. And we have a new variety now that's called Karst Giant, and the leaves, instead of being this wide, they're actually about 3 inches wide and about 4 inches long. So it's a new one that we're going to have available this next spring.
That's great. And then I noticed you have a really tree-lined eucalyptus grove here. And some of them were really nice, and some of them looked like they had some damage.
Yes, actually, after the winter, some of them were bent over clear to the ground with the ice this last winter. And we were surprised. Some of them we thought were going to be completely history, and they were fine and no damage at all. Others got some damage and are coming back. And some went clear to the ground. I cut them off with the chainsaw, and now they're coming up from the roots.
Oh, that's
so we're
great.
Really quite surprised there's one, the spinning gum, that is most spectacular, and there was absolutely no damage on that one. That was extra nice. So that was kind of a nice surprise to see that.
Very much. And so also the acacias. And I know that William has one, and he's kind of nervous about bringing it out and leaving it out, but you had some in the ground.
Yes, actually, we just planted them. It was in October of last year. It's Acacia dilbata, and after the freeze, I looked and I went, oh, the bark is splitting. I think this is history. Well, I didn't realize it, but the bark is actually peeling bark, and they're fine. I mean, they've grown twice the size as they were last fall when we planted them. So they're doing really well.
And then agave. I mean, everyone loves agave. It's really the big trend these days, but, you know, a lot of them are so tender, but you have some successive hardy ones.
Yes, actually, we've got agave perii truncata in the garden, and it's nice and silver. It looks sort of like a really huge pineapple. One of the things about agaves, though, even the tender ones, a lot of times you can dry them out and put them in your garage for the wintertime. Absolutely no light, no water, and put them out about March and they're fine.
Oh.
So most of the Zone 9 ones you can do that with.
Nice.
So it's kind of a nice thing that you can do in a container.
And then something kind of common, a lot of people have them, is the Italian cypress, where everybody is nervous about those, that they're going to be like very borderline, but you've had good success with that.
Yes. In fact, we just planted these last October. So they were in the ground 2 months before we had the frost.
Mm-hmm.
And with the ice storm, you know, they were bent in half, and I thought, uh-oh. No damage at all. Not one little needle it was damaged, and I was surprised. So they're actually quite a lot tougher than what people realize.
Well, I think that if you ever come out to Burl's, he has an open garden in May.
Yes.
You can go to the website, get all that information, and go look at all the beautiful plants and all the great descriptions. Thank you so much.
Thank you.